out unless the wits are thrown away. Amen. So, glory to God. And so that's one of the strategies of the enemy to affect the cause. Well, cause are based on thought patterns. You see? On thought patterns. So you, when you're dealing with schemes or even trying to change your outward world, look at the causation of why it's there. You can identify the cause, break the cause down, break the cause up, and institute a new reason on why you're doing something. Because that's going to guarantee another result. That's going to guarantee a different result. I wish I could be disciplined. I'm just not. You look around your house or look in your personal life or whatever, and things are just out of whack. Man, I wish I could be more organized. I want to be more organized. That's not going to do it. That's only part of you saying what you want. The other part is instituting the law of organization in your belief system. Breaking down the law of disorder. Amen. In your mindset or in your subconscious. Amen. Because as long as the thought process of disorder is in there, it's going to produce disorder. The effect of disorder is going to show up because disorder is in you. So don't get mad about the effect of things. If you want something changed, look at the cause. And usually the cause is going to emanate from you. Because if you can change you, you can gain the advantage over the enemy. Yeah. Because the Bible says we are not ignorant of his devices. And when Paul was talking about that, he was dealing with forgiveness. So if you have the ability to forgive, even if you're right, you keep the enemy from gaining the advantage over you. If you can forgive even when you're right, you keep the enemy from gaining the advantage over you. Because that's one of his devices that he uses is unforgiveness. A device is an object used to carry out a plan. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. So we see Delilah here as a choice vine in a torrent river. We see her, Samson. We also see the Philistines. Now, let's see here, and we'll be wrapping this up real soon. Let's put this into quick perspective on how these elements played out between their relationship. Okay? Now, the Philistines are having trouble with Samson. Because he's killing folk left and right. I mean, he took out 1,000 men at one time with a jawbone of a donkey. Just killed them. Just stripped them down. And you know what I'm saying? And so they're having problems with Samson. He's been a thorn in their flesh. Why? Because he is threatening their government. He's threatening their rule over the people. He's causing a revolt to take place. He's like a revolutionary. Remember, his purpose for being strong was to deliver Israel from the bondage of the Philistines. That was his purpose. And the enemy did not like the fact that Samson was having success like that. And the enemy couldn't do nothing with him. Remember, because he's limited. Satan is not all powerful. Okay? So, but one of his schemes is enticements. That's one of the schemes of the enemy. Enticements means to lead on by exciting hope or desire. To lead on by exciting hope or desire. Our main definition tonight was regulation, remember? Regulation means to control or direct by a rule, principle, or method to adjust to some standard or requirement, to systematize, reconcile, monitor, or tune up. That's what regulate means. another word for scheme, regulate, to control or direct by a rule, a principle, or method, to adjust to some standard or requirement, to systematize, reconcile, monitor, or turn or tune up. So the whole purpose of what Satan is trying to do, he's trying to tune you up to his way of living. He wants to put something in you to monitor your whereabouts. The reason why Jesus was so powerful, because Satan had nothing in him to monitor him or to adjust him or to regulate him. That's why he had such problems with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. One of our issues is that because of this flesh, he got something to work with. Y'all got to help me. Amen. He got something he can regulate. He got something that he can modify and adjust. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. And you can see that in the church and out of the church, that Satan is regulating the minds of people, the wills of people, the wills of children, the hearts of leaders. He's regulating them, telling them what to say, when to say, how to say it, what not to say, what to do, what not to do, how much to take, who to molest, who to talk to, who to be nice to, who to be mad at, who to be prejudiced against. Y'all got to help me. Amen. Praise God. Satan is regulating this activity. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because he's looking for control. He's losing control because of the saints of God are in this earth realm acting under the power of the Holy Ghost. And he knows that he cannot do anything substantial to a person filled with the Holy Ghost, because we have the advantage, we have the control, but many of us just don't know that yet. We don't know the power that we got. We don't know that we got a word that can move in 12 inches in a billionth of a second. We don't know that we got this word that's sharper than any two-edged sword, that can travel thousands of kilometers, amen, quicker than the sunlight can hit the earth. Amen, praise God. If we knew we have this type of authority, dominion, amen, and that demons were subject unto us, a lot of stuff that we dealt with, we wouldn't have even had to put up with, because we would have shut the enemy down. Hallelujah, somebody. Hallelujah. We would have shut him down. Just through the power of the word, we would have shut him down. Hallelujah, glory to God. Yeah. So, enticements, to lead on by exciting hope or desire, to allure, to attract, to bait, to beguile, to seduce, to turn or prevail. Okay? Now check this out. We have the Philistines using Delilah as what? As bait. What enticed Delilah to be used as bait? I do believe that Delilah was an okay lady at first. I don't see anything in the scriptures to let me know that something was wrong with her, other than her just being a lady like a man. That's just me. That's what I see. I haven't dug real deep into her life, but I do see an issue with money with her. I do see an issue with money. Because when the lords of the Philistines, there were about five of them, a lord over each city. They had five cities of the Philistines. Each promised her 11 pieces of silver. 1,100 pieces of silver. That was equivalent to only about, what, about $3,500. Yeah. It's about 30, yeah, between about $1,500, $3,500 in American money. That's what she was offered. Maybe back then that was a lot. But to me, that's a hit. There they go again, putting out an assassination on somebody, the Philistines. See what I'm saying? Using her as a hit woman. If you tell us where, yeah, check this out, another scheme of the enemy, using somebody that's designed, adjusted to what you like, as a hit, and you don't know it. Not really after you. Not really after you physically. That's just the enticement. The enemy is not after you physically. He's after your vow. He's after your commitment. Ah, glory to God, because within your commitment is power. Within your commitment is the channel through which the Holy Ghost flows and is guaranteed to operate in your life. As long as you keep the commandments of the Lord, y'all got to help me, amen. As long as you keep these precepts and examples and hearken diligently onto His word, amen, praise God, He's going to increase you more and more. That's a guarantee. Your obedience is a guarantee that God is on your side. Hallelujah, glory to God. Amen.